Hi, I'm glad to see you. Today, we make another painting, so prepare your colors, brushes, and be ready to go.
All the colors will be in the description below, so let's get started. Now, usually, I start with putting some thin coat of any type of color, but this time, I will use only the linseed oil and nothing else. You will see. With a little brush, with linseed oil. We'll cover the entire canvas. Thin coat, only the oil. This is the base acrylic. It's black, flat, and dry. Nicely flat. Now at this point the entire canvas is covered up with oil. But what if we put there too much? We'll scrape it off. Just like this. You can see how much dirt is left on this paper. Okay. If you are trying to do the same thing on the clear canvas without any coating, the oil will be sucked into the fabric. So prepare your canvas before. So now I will start with a small load of yellow and let's just say start somewhere here. Something like this. Now I will clean this brush. I load this brush with a very small amount of red. Now I will go just around. You can even mix here a bit. Now this is the new green. I will use it's permanent green, very small amount. Sorry, okay, camera back. Now I put very small amount, just a touch here and here. Then I will use Monstrial Blue. It's very bright. And phthalo blue. Maybe with a touch of a black. Yeah. Very sudden touch. Here and here, just a bit. Okay. Now comes the form part. We'll blend this thing up. Not completely. Just to bring a few colors together. like this. Now with white, let's do a path like this, like for a cloud. Very easy. Just plain white. You can see I'm using the same brush that I cleaned up this one before. This is a firm white. If you are trying to do this particular piece with me with a thin white, it will be significantly harder, even impossible maybe. Okay, now let's blend this up. We start from a center and work outwards. Now we are creating just a base for what we will do next. Now, here comes a second layer. Now, this layer will not be blend. So, overlay our path which we created. Just like this, you can use step, you can use circle motion, you can. Whether we want to achieve this. You can see this will be a crazy painting. Now I put here a linseed oil to thin this white. It's complete like water or ink. Like this. Now with the help of a paint palette knife, we'll go and spark this place a bit. Okay, now we'll continue and I will add a touch of a yellow to this part on top of our white, just there and there, very small touch. Now same with red. And same for the green, which we put there.
using sorry, the same brush. So the all colors are overlaid. Same for the blue. And of course we use phthalo blue too. Okay, so now are the all the stars, which you can see right here, are just white. So the same process as we made for, as we used for these stars, we'll use with the same color. Just we'll sprinkle it up with yellow, red, green, blue. Reload. Here comes yellow. Here comes green. Just a bit. Now blue. Monstrial blue. And the last blue is phthalo blue. Okay, now I will tap a bit with a clean brush.
Or we can just put there small, very tiny bit of a phthalo blue and black. We can use touch of white. Okay, this looks pretty good. Now, you know, I decided to just add a few white spots over this one. Nice. Now let's make a mountain. For that I will use phthalo blue, black, small amount, and very small touch of a green. A touch of white. Okay, now smaller roll of paint. And now let's just do a mountain right here. Let's put another peak right there. Another one. Why not? Now, scrape all the paint this here, all the excess paint from the peaks. Less paint there will be easier for you to work with. Now with brush, which we use for our blending, we'll do a push or pull. Very easy.
Now, I can model where the highlights will be. You can further remove the paint.
Okay.
Now we have a very small roll of paint on the edge of a knife.
I hope you can see it.
We'll go and just... Well, don't worry about anything else. Just about this. It's nice that this color, what is created right there from the base, it's mixing up. That creates a very beautiful tones, which are on the spot. With this part I have so much fun. Now I will start adding more white to some places. And don't forget to clean your palette knife. Lightly touching. Very light. And go by the same angle, like this. This is the most relaxing part of entire painting, cleaning and painting. Okay, now let's say that we'll add a small touch of a green to our white, very small. We'll just, okay. Mix this up. Same goes for blue. We'll add some blue to our snow, like reflection. We can blend some parts. You can overlay them. That's the beauty of a oil-based painting. You can go over and over many times. Same will go for red. Just a bit, very small touch. If somewhere is too much, we can grab a small, or we can just scrape that off. And overlay. Maybe we can use small touch of dark blue. Well. Maybe this part needed more white, so add there more white. Okay. Now I'll pull just a base. Maybe we can pull this part a little bit further. Now we have a highlights, so let's do a shadows real quick. we'll use this mountain color. With a small touch of a white. Mix that up. Maybe more of the dark color. I just try to scrape this off, okay? This will be perfect, okay. Nothing hard, very easy. This. Okay. Oops. I'll just fix that real quick. With some white, okay. Small yellow. Small touch of a green. And touch of a blue.
Now our mountain is finished. Now we don't need any red color right here from the start, so we'll scrape that off like this. Now let's do some trees. So for that I will use pure black, very strong. And all the phthalo blue. A small touch of a leftover white. Let's focus. Okay. Wiggle and pull and pull back. So on the tip there will be a small amount of that color. Now let's add some trees. So reload our brush. Each time reload your brush. If your paint is too thick, it will start blending with this white. So if you will dull it with a small drop of a oil, it will certainly help. Okay. Now with small brush, go and you'll do a peak. And another. One, like this, maybe, I don't know, one right here. You know what? I have a smaller different plan. I will remove this. Okay. I decided that I first and I will add ground. Now we flatten this color a bit. Like this. Before doing a water reflections, let's paint this entire bottom. Or with a black. Straight as possible, like this. I decided I will go back to our trees. This angle, this angle, this angle. Just a small rotation. Very sudden, but powerful. And can create all of these trees. We can use a bit dark color. Okay. Let's add another one right there. Okay, now let's cover these real quick. We're trying to cover just the base, nothing else.
Let's add just some some highlights on our trees. We'll just create some land, the edge. Now I will mix small amount of Monstreal blue to the brush with a touch of white. Let's just make some bushes. Now to our picture we can add a bit of a black.
That easy. Now let's add the waterline. Small roll of paint on the edge. Let's just blend this part. Now, obvious part right here is missing, and that is the galaxy up there. So let's just mirror it right there. We'll use the same process. So let's add a bit of yellow. Maybe more red. A touch of more yellow. Again, green. Blue. and phthalo blue. And small touch of black. Now we'll go and blend this up. Just try to remove all the necessary paint. The less the better. Maybe just a touch of more of that yellow. Now let's just blend this up too. Clean your brush, of course. Reflections are distorted, so you don't have to do exact same thing what is right up there, just approximate. Now another layer of white, very small, however, not like up right here, a bit smaller. And now let's add some yellow to it. A touch of red. Blue, of course. Oh, green. Green. Green goes first.
green.
Now comes blue. Let's try to very gently blend up. Oh, before, we need some stars. I will not blend all of the stars, what will be there. Just this part will be blend, this one not. Okay, now, or should we blend this? You know what? Let's keep it as it is. It's nice. We'll just add a bit more yellow manually. Do a white too. Okay, and continue with all the stars. Yellow, red, green, blue. Be careful to not cover any snow with yellow. Okay, here comes green. Just a bit. Now blue. Let's add one big tree. Why not? Just right here. Maybe it should be a little bit darker. A lot darker. Okay, now we'll go and use the small brush which we used on these trees. Now in this area I will use a thicker paint so it won't mix, and if it does it will be a very subtle. To the bottom completely, like this. Maybe we should make this bigger so this part will not be visible. Much better. Now let's add a highlights. There was a small camera error. I forgot to start the video, so I just added two small bushes right there and small path like this. Land. Very small path, subtle one. Now the last thing what we will do, we'll grab a palette knife. And we'll scrape there and there some branches. It adds another layer of complexity. It's much, much nicer. It's quick. Very nice. And we are done.
So this is a finished painting. I really never done anything close to this one, so I really want to hear your opinion. And as always, I hope you enjoy the process and being with me. And with that said, see you soon. Goodbye.